This is Delta Launch Control. We're now 1 hour, 3 minutes, 58 seconds into the flight of the Delta II with the SMAP spacecraft. And at this time, we are joined by Tim Dunn, who is our NASA launch manager in today's countdown and the flight of the Delta II. And Tim, first of all, take us right from the top. What have we just seen as far as the spacecraft and the vehicle, and what do we look like?
Oh, we look great, George. I guess most people saw that wonderful spacecraft separation video that we had transmitted back to us from our African ground station.
Clear as a bell.
It was spectacular. So you saw a clean spacecraft separation from the Delta II second stage, and then a few, about a 30 seconds later or so, you saw the solar arrays begin to deploy. So we've got good telemetry from the spacecraft, so we're in contact with SMAP. Everything looks good right now. The initial sequence of deployment of solar arrays is underway, and we just couldn't be happier.
And Delta II, from liftoff through the second stage, how did that perform?
Delta II, it's a workhorse. That's why what we call it, and it's performed yet again. Had a beautiful performance during first stage flight. We had an initial burn of the second stage to put us into our insertion orbit. And then we coasted for roughly 40 minutes or so prior to an adjustment burn of the second stage. And then we proceeded into spacecraft separation.
Well, the countdown was certainly like our first attempt. And I mean, all the way down to the last couple of minutes.
It was very similar. Very similar. I just can't say enough about the team that we have. We had zero launch vehicle problems on Delta II. We had zero spacecraft problems. The 30th Space Wing continues to provide rock-solid support. Not a single range piece of instrumentation went down. Absolutely spectacular performance from all of the agencies contributing to the SMAP mission.
And who all is involved in that last discussion about the upper level winds to know that we actually had a go condition?
So obviously we were red throughout the countdown, like we were on our first attempt for upper level winds. We had four balloons that were released. All were returning red data indicating that we just could not find the correct trajectory and flight path to get through that maximum dynamic pressure region of flight. However, on that fourth balloon, we begin to see a little bit of improvement. Although the numbers were red, we saw the ability, once those two additional balloons came in, that we could then get the appropriate curve fits in and find our way. So we had indications about 10 minutes prior to launch. We went ahead and adjusted the T0 almost 2 minutes to the right to give us just a little more time to do that processing. But that's a combined team of balloons being released here at Vandenberg Air Force Base by the 30th Space Wing weather folks. And then that data is being collected here locally, transmitted to the ULA Denver winds team in Denver, Colorado. They're crunching the numbers, and they're finding us a way forward. So roughly at about L minus 10 minutes, L minus 8 minutes, we saw that we were going to get some green data, and you immediately saw us be able to tell that to the launch team and then begin processing toward our T0.
So it was a very coordinated effort there in the last 10 minutes or so to get us to that last point where we knew we were go.
It was coordinated, and it was even practiced. We actually went through the same methodical techniques with the ULA Denver winds team and the LSP winds analysts working side by side, evaluating that data. We did that on the first attempt, but that last push that we made on that remained red. Today was a totally different story. We were able to go green with that upper level wind data, and it resulted in us being able to have a successful launch.
Well, Tim, it's good that we've had practically two back-to-back successful Delta II launches, and we have a little gap here now, and then we got a couple of more, I believe.
We do. So on the heels of the OCO2 success last summer here at Vandenberg, we now have SMAP. We have two remaining Delta II NASA missions that are manifested. The first is a weather satellite called JPSS-1. Currently, we're targeting November of 2016 here from Vandenberg at Slick 2. And then about 6 months to 8 months after JPSS, we have a mission called ISAT 2 that we're going to launch on Delta 2.
Well, Tim, thank you very much, and congratulations to you and the LSP team, and we'll look forward to seeing you back at the Cape.
Oh, great, George. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And we're now at T-minus, or T-plus. T-plus 1 hour, 9 minutes, 25 seconds, and counting. This is Delta Launch Control.